Today on Emerging Business Report, Thomas Moorehead, CEO of BMW of Sterling, demonstrates how managing resources, great customer service, and choosing the best employees play a part in being successful.
Welcome to another edition of the Emerging Business Report, brought to you by the Center for Minority Business Development at Prince George's Community College. Thank you for tuning in. I'm your host, Sharon Morton. Joining us today is Thomas Moorehead, owner of BMW of Sterling, a 39,000 square foot state-of-the-art facility with separate showrooms for the BMW and Mini Cooper brands. The Moorehead store was among the first 70 BMW dealerships in the United States selected to sell the revitalized Mini Cooper brand. BMW of Sterling is one of a select group of dealerships to earn the coveted quality service designation from BMW, and sales of the Mini Cooper brand rank among the top five in the nation. Black Enterprise magazine named Moorehead its 2007 Car Dealer of the Year, and Time magazine named BMW of Sterling Dealer of the Year in 2008. Mr. Moorehead, thank you for joining us here on Emerging Business Report.
Well, thanks for having me.
Tell me, what motivated you to start out in car sales?
Well, I actually started out at the University of Michigan.
Okay.
And switched over to car sales on the urging of a good friend and fraternity brother who started me out about 25 years ago. And I have been very happy with the transition in light of the fact that the industry is so bad right now.
Well, this has been a tough economy, especially for car dealerships. Tell us how you're able to stay on top.
Well, the real key right now is really watching your resources and realizing who's the boss. And the boss at our center is not Tom Moorehead, it's Mr. and Mrs. Customer who walks through the door.
Boss is the customer.
Absolutely. And I always say, and I tell my staff, that without them, we might as well close our doors. And that's in any business, though. And managing your resource, that is managing your cash.
And customer loyalty is really vital in any business. How are you able to maintain customer loyalty at BMW of Sterling?
Well, it really entails understanding who's the boss, as I said, and bending over backwards to make sure every time they walk through the door that you're there to service them. And we service on an average about 130 to 40 cars a day.
That's
and
great.
So when you're servicing that many cars, you have a lot of bosses to take care of. So it's critical that you meet each and every one of them's need, and the 134 employees that we have there have to understand that and perform each and every day.
So would you say you rely mostly on service, the service part of the car dealership, or the sales of cars?
I rely on the service side. You can buy a car from anybody, but it's the service that you want, because that's the long-term experience. And you're looking for each one of those individuals based on their sphere of influence to send you business. So it's critical that you take very good care of them in order to be able to continue that business and get them back in the store to buy again.
And get them to spread the word.
Absolutely. Because we're not looking to sell one car. We're looking to sell you all of your cars.
For a lifetime.
For a lifetime.
Okay.
And I used to always tell young dealers when I was starting out that on the domestic side, that each time we sold a car, it represented about, at that time, about $436,000.
And wow. How does that work? What do you mean it represents $436,000?
Well, if you look at the number of cars that you will purchase during your lifetime, say for an example, you're purchasing roughly four cars, and you look at the service experience of each of those individuals.
I see.
And those experiences. And every time they have a good experience, they will tell others.
I see.
And that gets you repeat and referral business.
Yeah, especially service. People are always looking for a good service dealership that does the job right the first time.
Absolutely.
And they don't feel like they're being taken for granted or they're spending way too much money.
Absolutely.
Let's go back some. Okay. When you first opened your dealership, a lot of people who start out with new business ventures have a difficult time finding capital.
Absolutely.
How did you go about securing capital to open the dealership?
Ironically, it was one of those situations of going to the various lending institutions in the area. But having a BMW brand, okay, what we call at that time a letter of intent, and presenting that along with my credentials is what allowed me to get my, as one says, your foot in the door, to at least talk to them. And once you sell yourself, okay, then that's really in essence what happened. Now, the manufacturer has a financing arm as well. So it's a combination of trying, in my case, to get the best deal in order to make it happen. And that is in terms of getting the best rate for the money that I was trying to borrow.
Do you believe minorities have a tougher time or more challenges in opening and sustaining their businesses, getting
Absolutely.
The loans that's needed?
Absolutely. Many times when you walk in and you're talking to a lending institution, especially when you have the color hue that we have, okay, they question whether or not you have the business acumen to be able to perform. So you have to have a good track record. For many young people who are starting out, it's extremely hard.
Yes.
Because they haven't had a chance to build that reputation. And that's what's tough for them.
Yes. What would you recommend to people who are just starting out in business? What should they do? How should they go about finding and getting that capital and proving themselves?
Well, one of the keys is perhaps going to work for someone and understanding the business. Getting a chance to work for someone else, learn the business, and once you do, you can take that experience along with the capital that you have, and you have to try and convince the financial institution that you can do the job.
We're going to talk some more about that when we come back after
okay.
this break, Mr. Moorehead. Thank you for joining us here. Please stay tuned. We'll be right back after these messages.
You have to be able to sell your product and service your product and do it well. But in addition to that, you have to be a good corporate citizen.
I think that, quite frankly, the sky is the limit for the Center for Minority Business Development. They are fast becoming an entity in this county that small and large businesses are looking to for the services that they offer.
Come and visit us at the Center for Minority Business Development, and we can surely help you out.
To the Emerging Business Report. We have the pleasure of speaking with Mr. Thomas Moorehead, CEO and Chairman of the Board for BMW of Sterling, one of the top five dealerships in Virginia and among the top 10% of all BMW centers in the nation. Mr. Moorehead, again, thanks for being here.
Again, thanks for having me.
Now, I wanted to talk about what it takes to reach your level of success and build your brand. That must have taken years.
Oh, it did. It did. As I look back on it, one of the major things you have to do is become a good corporate citizen.
What does that mean?
In my case, it meant you can sell product, you can service product, but it's all about who you are in the community, how you represent the brand, having the right brand, having the right location, but working in the community. My wife and I are constantly looking for ways to assist in our community. And one of the ways that we do that is through our foundation.
Okay.
And that foundation, of course, for us is one that we have chosen to look at education. And that is addressing the needs of young people going to school. And we also have what we call a therapeutic riding program that we support.
And therapeutic that, riding program?
Correct.
Okay, what is that?
Well, it's a organization over in Great Falls, and we have handicapped kids who ride horses, and that is one of the best programs that we have supported in a number of years. And the reason being is that handicapped kids have an opportunity to come and ride horses, and for many of them to get that close to a horse as big as they are, you know, it's like, oh, they're afraid, they really don't want to ride. But once they get on and see the natural movement of that horse and feel it, okay, they're so happy and they want to come back the next time.
So reaching out to the community is part of your definition of success.
Absolutely. You have to be able to sell your product and service your product and do it well. But in addition to that, you have to be a good corporate citizen.
Okay. What should a person look for when selecting a car dealership to buy a car? So many times people are very wary of car dealers. But we know that your car dealership is known for quality and service. What should people be looking for?
Well, I think you need to look at and examine, first of all, what are they willing to do for you? Over and beyond that of just selling you a car. Because when your needs are there, for an example, we provide loaner cars. When I started out, we washed every car and did them by hand. Now we've probably gotten a little too big for that, and we're getting ready to purchase a couple of car washers to be able to address it. But if you make a mistake and you're not perfect, you're not going to fix every car right the first time. But when that happens, be willing to admit you've made a mistake. In the old days when I started, I had what was called an oops car.
An oops car?
Yes.
What's that?
And I used to always say, don't make an excuse, face it up front and say, we made a mistake. Now that you have made that mistake, go out and do the very best job you can to correct it. That is, go pick up the car, bring it back, leave them a car, address that need, get it back to them, and make sure. We used to send out homemade coffee cakes.
Homemade coffee cakes to the customer.
To the customer.
Okay.
Because I wanted to leave a good taste in their mouth.
Wow,
okay?
That's great.
As a result of
Love it. I got to come out and buy a car from you.
Please do.
Okay, so your customers appreciated that, and that
Absolutely.
Kept them coming back.
That's what service is all about.
Okay.
I mean, they don't have a problem if you make a mistake, but facing the fact that you made that mistake and addressing that need is what's key.
Yeah, I wish more dealers were like you.
Oh, well, I wish we had more too, because our industry would have a better reputation.
Exactly.
And that's what's great.
Now, we talked about your being among the very few African Americans that own a car dealership, but you were the first African American member of the BMW Dealers Council in 2006. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, you have to understand, now, BMW didn't have a lot of people who looked like me.
Right.
And as a result of that, and you have to develop a reputation. My first year in business, we came very close to winning the Center of Excellence Award. And as a result of that, we tried to build on that. They only selected in our group six dealers. And I was tied with three other dealers, and they told me I lost by a tenth of a point. And I don't know what point, what happened there, but I always vowed that we were going to get it the next time. So we just kept working hard. But along the way, the management of BMW recognized the fact that we were working real hard. Plus, we wanted to make sure that we had other BMW dealers that looked like me. So I was always pushing to try and get more of us into the brand. And that's been a real key as well.
But the council, what does the BMW council actually do?
We actually looked at and represented the dealers who, based on a regional basis, you know, the dealers would come in and tell us what some of the critical issues that they were facing, and then we would take those issues back to the manufacturer and advocate on their behalf.
Oh,
so that was the reason that it was so key for us, is to have representation on that council.
I can't tell you how happy we are to have you here today, Mr. Moorehead. We have one more segment after this, so I have a million more questions I want to ask you. So you'll stick around, right?
Yes, I will.
And we hope you'll stick around, too. We'll be right back after these messages here on the Emerging Business Report.
20% of the people that you hire are your superstar. And then 70% really are those who are kind of the ones that maintain the organization. Then there's 10% that we're constantly evaluating, and those are the ones that you need to replace.
You've got to be a motivator, and that encompasses being a strong leader. But you've got to have other folks and keep other folks believing in what you're saying, and frankly, being able to perform at a level that yields a positive result.
Again for joining us here on the Emerging Business Report. Thomas Moorehead, BMW of Sterling's Chief Executive Officer, is our guest. Mr. Moorehead, you've shared so much valuable information. I wanted to ask you about your ownership in the hotel industry. You've really diversified, so talk a little bit about that.
I guess it was one of those situations of my next door neighbor who kept saying to me, you should look at the hospitality industry. And I said, well, I don't know anything about it. And he said, you can make money in something other than the car business. And after nudging me for a long time, we finally decided to take a look. And that's how I ended up getting along with Bob Johnson, and talked to Bob about it as well. And Bob convinced me, along with some others, that it was a good business, and I've really been pleased.
BET founder and former owner, Bob Johnson. So what, you have an interest in a hotel right here at the National Harbor.
Yes, the Residence Inn here at National Harbor. I hope you get a chance to go over and enjoy it.
I will. I definitely will.
Okay.
How has it been treating you, the business?
Very well. We've been extremely blessed. And this is a unique market. And I say unique in the sense that because there's so many military installations around us, we get a lot of multiple stays, along with there's so many. And this is a great area out here. There are so many family reunions that take place out here. And when you have an atmosphere like this one, it allows people to kind of walk freely around, and it's just so many nice shops and restaurants.
It's a beautiful
area. It's just a beautiful area.
Yeah. If you knew then what you know now about owning a car dealership, being in the car business, what would you change? What would you do differently?
Well, the real key in business is surrounding yourself with good people. And I always say that surround yourself with people that are even better than you, okay? Getting good talent is some of the things that I feel is really key for us in terms of our survival. I've always tried to get not what is considered just because I had a certain amount of money, but go out and find the best that I could hire for the money that I had. That's really the key. And if you do that in the beginning, it will help you in terms of some of the mistakes you make when you first start out.
That's easier said than done, though. It's very hard to find good employees, employees who care just as much about the business as you do. How do you go about doing that?
Well, one of the things that I tried to do was I utilized a service that was able to evaluate each of our employees. And I had them to take a little profile test.
Your employees took a profile test.
Yes, indeed. Because I wanted to make sure, because I couldn't afford to make personnel kind of decision that I would regret. And I wanted to look at the predictability profiles that said, this individual will probably do a good job in the position that you're trying to put them in. And if they didn't fit, then I would have to proceed with getting someone else.
And is that something you'd recommend to business owners?
Absolutely.
When they're looking for good quality employees?
Take the time and hire the best person that you can the first time around.
And sometimes the best cost more.
Absolutely. And pay a little bit more. I have a formula that says that it's 20, 70, 10, and that is 20% of the people that you hire are your superstar. And then 70% really are those who are kind of the ones that maintain the organization. And then there's 10% that we're constantly evaluating, and those are the ones that you need to replace. And you need to continue to do that by department.
Hmm. Where do you see BMW of Sterling in 5 or 10 years from today?
Well, I tell you, we are getting ready to embark upon expanding our component now. We are moving across the street. I'm in the process of buying 8 acres of land there. I'm going to put a sales component over there and 48 additional service bays.
Great.
So that'll get me up to a total of 78. And hopefully with that, I'll be in a position to continue to service our clients in this area.
Mr. Moorehead, I wish you continued success.
Oh, thank you. You're obviously
doing a fantastic job. We can't thank you enough for being here on Emerging Business Report.
Oh, well, it's a pleasure.
Yes, and I want to thank you for joining us today. Please be sure to tune in for the next Emerging Business Report. Have a great day.